What round, Devin?
Bill.
Seven? Seven for Devin?
That was Devin Haney right before his fight with Ryan Garcia predicting a seventh round knockout. Ironically, that's the round Ryan Garcia almost knocked him out. And if it wasn't for the help that he got from Harvey, the referee, then Ryan would have won seventh round knockout and made a lot of people very, very rich. But they were robbed from that opportunity. Here's what Devin Haney has to say today about this. He says, first off, I want to say, Alhamdulillah, Allah is the perfect planner, and I trust his plan no matter what. I came up short, but this is boxing, and if anyone knows me, they know that I am a true competitor and always wanted to test my skills against the best fighters in the world. So this is the first thing Devin Haney says. It's a long message. This is part one. I'll continue. Ryan, despite the circumstances, was victorious that night, and that's fine. I do feel like weight played a role in it, but only Allah knows. I would love to run it back and give the fans a fair fight within the agreed weight. Devin goes on to say, with that being said, I'm currently enjoying time with my family and friends as well as making up my days of Ramadan. Thank you to all my supporters and everyone involved in making this fight happen. After I finish making up my days of Ramadan, I will tell you guys what's next. And he has another thing going on here. I'm going to share it with you up next. Devin closes. I appreciate everyone that has reached out. I am overwhelmed with love. I will be back better than ever, inshallah. Thank you, Oscar De La Hoya and Golden Boy Promotions, Eddie Hearn, and all of Matchroom, The Zone, Mauricio Suleiman of the WBC, and the WBC, and all of Devin Haney Promotions. Great night of boxing, alhamdulillah. So, Devin Haney did not say what's next for him. He did say he wants a rematch with Ryan at a fair weight, but Ryan's not fighting at anything less than 143, so I don't think that rematch happens anytime soon. It sounds good, but I don't think it's realistic. So what are his other options? Well, he's champion, so he has to fight his mandatory Sandor Martin. There's not going to be a lot of interest in that fight. It's still a dangerous fight because Martin doesn't have a lot of power, but is a very good boxer. His other option is to try to unify. He says he wants to fight the best, so rematch Ryan at 143. Both of you guys make the same weight. That's an option. Or fight Subriel Matias, a massive puncher at 140. I don't think Devin wants to do that. Fight Pitbull Cruz, another massive puncher. I don't think Devin wants to do that. Teofimo Lopez, another massive puncher. So maybe vacates and moves up to 47. Maybe he could find some action. Mario Barrios up there or something else. But maybe he could fight Conor Benn. So definitely a lot of options for Devin, but he's suspended right now for 6 to 9 months because of the loss, because it's called a medical suspension, and he could be cleared. So he's not even allowed to be in the gym for about 6 months. It varies. It could be 2 months. It could be, for Ryan, they gave him a 1 week suspension. But anybody else, it depends. Sometimes it's 9 months after an ugly knockout, and he took a lot of beating. So Devin really didn't dive into it and didn't explain a lot about the fight. He just said he felt that the weight, Ryan's weight, played a difference. But Ryan says that Devin weighed more than him on fight night. So there was no rehydration clause, but, you know, it is what it is. So they could have put one on when Ryan missed weight, but they didn't. They could have also said, we're not fighting Ryan because he missed weight, but they didn't. So they wanted to fight him. It was a massive event. And unfortunately for Devin, a lot of his weaknesses got exposed, and now there's a lot of buzz in boxing. Does he stay with Bill, or does he find a new coach? I've seen a lot of him. Antonio Tarver down the list. Gabe Rosado has mentioned some stuff, and a lot of people have said that. So it will be interesting to see. I saw also, of course, Floyd Mayweather went on live with Bill yesterday, and that's getting a lot of buzz. I shared that. And we'll see what's next for Devin, but definitely he has to reflect, he has to see. And the question is, will he ever be the same? Derek James questioned that, and so did other people as well. Did this loss to Ryan Garcia change him forever? Will he come back better? Will he come back worse? Will he get hit with a punch and have PTSD and we won't see him fight again? So lots and lots of question marks. He should vacate the title, fight two easy tune-ups, get his confidence back, work it out and go from there. But if he fights any of the killers at 140, he may be in trouble. But I don't know. What do you guys think? Let me know. Stay tuned. FaizNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Secback reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter at Secback. You can follow me on Instagram at Ellie Secback.
Ellie Secback reporting.
For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Eli Sekback reporting.
ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Eli Sekback reporting.